Hey guys, welcome back to another tutorial. The copy I am using in this tutorial is from Classmate, and I have kept some extra pages below this working page. And today I will show you how to do blending using this Staedtler Luna pencils. I have the one in 12 shades, plus I got one extra free with the set. So this is the color card, and here you can see these two shades can be used for skin, plus they are water soluble, so you can use them easily with water. So I purchased this set from a local store, but anyway I will be putting the Amazon links below in the description box, and the color names aren't mentioned on the pencils, which is a negative point from my side. Sometimes it becomes difficult to keep a track of the color pencils we are using, so it's better to keep a swatch card with you. And here you can see that I have already applied the first layer of the color, which is a lighter creamish color, and now I am applying water to blend it completely. While blending your skin, always give the pencil strokes at the corners and then use your brush to blend it towards the inside. And also you can keep a tissue paper with you so that you can dry your brush in between. And here you can see that this is also how you can take the colors directly from the pencil to apply it at very minute areas. Let the first layer dry, then you can use your second layer of the color. And here you can see that I am using this brown shade, and I will apply it at the corners and then again use water to blend it. Always work with very light hands when you are coloring the skin, and don't forget to highlight the collarbones. I think that plays a very important role in the croquis or the body rendering. So do render your skin very properly, and you can see how I am putting the color at the corners, and then I will use my brush to blend it inside. Also, do try out this tissue paper trick. I always follow this because sometimes while picking up water with our brush, we tend to pick too much water, which can eventually spoil the illustration because too much water will smudge everything. So do dry your brush after picking up water. Also, I will show you how to draw the hair using these pencils as well. So the first step would be to give some light strokes using this pencil. I am using the black shade, and then I will use water to smudge everything. So after this layer dries up, we will then move to the next step, which is giving dry pencil strokes, which I will show you in some time. Also, you can use the tissue paper to dry your skin more sooner if there is any amount of excess water left that will be absorbed by the tissue paper. And I always use these micron fineliners to give my detailing, like the eyebrows and the eyes, and the tip of the nose. So the base of my hair has dried up and now I'm using this dry pencil strokes to give the fine detailing of the hair, you can see. And make sure your pencil is sharpened enough to give the look of the fine strands of the hair. Also, I always like adding some shadows below my face, you can see, and you can smudge it using some water that will give a look of the shadow below your face. You can add some fine lines of the hair which will give a more natural look to your hair, and also you can use the black pencil to give some shadows and lines to your hands and the legs. So I am done with my skin rendering here, you can see. Now let us quickly move to the garment rendering now. The first step would be to give some fine strokes of the pencil. I'm using the reddish tone from my set and then use water to blend everything. And here you can see I have already marked the folds in my garment with a pencil, and this will help you as a guide while you are coloring later on. Here you can see how I am using water to give a very translucent or sheer look to the fabric. Now this will help us later on while we are giving the folds and the highlights of the garment. So guys, always remember when you are working with pencil mediums, always give your strokes uniformly and to one single direction. And that will also help you to blend easily. I mean, when you are using water over the pencil strokes, that will also look more nice and plain. Now I will use these pencil colors as a dry medium to give the strokes towards the direction of the folds in the garment. So the pressure of your hand matters a lot when you are blending with color pencils. I mean, if you want the maximum output of these pencil colors, apply very good amount of pressure. And when you want a light stroke, you just apply less pressure. So that's how you can manipulate your pencil medium to do the blending on the garments. I will suggest you to take some reference pictures and practice them to understand the folds in the garment. That will be very helpful to you. And here also you can see how I am applying more pressure and very dark strokes at the corners of the garment, and there is some light highlights in the front and the middle of the garment. So yes, that's how you can manipulate the single pencil color in creating various dimensions. The use of black pencil is very good when you want to show some high shine fabrics like satin. So you can use this in the extreme corners or behind the legs or at the folds to show the extreme shadows in your garments. And also don't forget to blend your black strokes using your main color or the earlier pencil which I have used. You can see I'm using that same pencil to blend my black shadows. I will also quickly show you how I draw this metal belt. I am giving the strokes of the brown pencil and using water to smudge it. Also, I took little black on my brush and I am giving it on the metal belt and let this layer dry. Then I will do the next step. And also you can give some more fine detailing using water over your garment. So guys, this is an optional step which I am showing you. If you want more smooth blending, you can take your brush and you can run it over your illustration to give more smooth blending of the color pencil strokes. Lastly, I will give some black lines over this belt to give the look of the metallic belt. So you can see by using just a brown pencil and a black pencil how the look is done. You can finish your illustration by giving some final detailing using your black pencil. You can outline your arms and the legs and give some shadows. So guys, I hope this was useful enough to everybody and you can try out your own artworks using these techniques which I have shown you. And don't forget to show me your artworks on my Instagram. I would love to see your works. And right now I am working on all your recommended videos. So do recommend me more ideas if you have. And I will see you in the next one. Till then, take care.